Hello aspirants, looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 18 December. On the front page you have this news: Congress leader Sajjan Kumar gets life term in anti-Sikh riots case. So this is a long running case of Delhi riots in 1984, anti-Sikh riots, in which Delhi High Court has now convicted the Congress leader Sajjan Kumar for murder of 5 people in Rajnagar in Delhi. So this was post Indira Gandhi's assassination, that anti-Sikh riots with which many Congress members were also involved was seen, and now a conviction has come after 34 years. Then this is Congress chief ministers take oath in 3 states. We have been discussing this. Then this is Delhi offers $1.4 billion aid package to Mali to tackle financial crisis. So this is India-Maldives relation now improving with the new president in place who has come on a visit to the country too. So this is Ibrahim Ahmad Soleh. So this is important. On page 3 you have Supreme Court seeks explanation from Rajasthan government. So this is regarding hate speech videos which have been uploaded by one Shambhulal Raigar. So from Rajasthan, from Jodhpur jail, he uploaded these hate speeches. So now Supreme Court is questioning the government on this. On page 5 you have Cyclone Fitai crosses the coast near Kakinada in AP. So heavy rains are being seen in East and West Godavari districts of Andhra Pradesh due to this Cyclone Fitai. And this is transgender pilgrims allowed into Sabarimala. So the Sabarimala temple entry case has been prominent, and now transgenders have been allowed to travel to Sabarimala. On page 6, you have 5 days on, no trace of trapped miners. So this is regarding Meghalaya's East Jayantia Hills. Here, rescue efforts are on to save the miners. One person has also been held in connection with this incident. So 13 miners were reportedly trapped in a rat hole coal mine in Meghalaya's East Jayantia Hill district. On page 7, you have LPG scheme to cover poor people. So Ujjwala scheme of the government, Ujjwala Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana, would be expanded. So it aims to provide deposit free LPG connection to all poor households. Then this is High Court ban. E-pharmacies mull legal recourse. So the Madras High Court has passed a judgment banning the sale of medicines online. So this is going to be challenged legally too, is what e-pharmacies are looking for, working towards. And this is IF plane takes to the air on blended biofuel. So this is Indian Air Force plane which flew with blended biofuel. So India became among the countries which have developed, tested and certified the process. On the editorial page, the first editorial is The Shadow of 1984. So this is regarding the front page news, Sajjan Kumar's conviction in the anti-Sikh riots case. So it says this reignites hope of substantial justice for riot victims. And second editorial, right prescription. So this is regarding Delhi High Court restoring retail sale and private manufacture of life-saving drug, oxytocin. And then the lead article, centrism holds in India. So this is regarding Congress again coming back in power. So it says Congress succeeded by offering itself as the default alternative for farmers and the youth, not by soft Hindutva. And the second editorial, the second article, not a decisive factor. So it says it is misleading to say that nota determines the assembly election results. So this article actually talks about nota. Nota is none of the above in elections. So you have this option too, that you don't elect any. Then on the op-ed page you have this article, hot air at Katowice. So this is regarding COP24 of UNFCCC, which took place in Katowice, Poland. So here the rule book has been finalized. So the key issues of concerns for the poorest and developing nations were either diluted or postponed. So this article discusses that. And this is an article on social audits, making every citizen an auditor. On page 10 you have the news here. Center suggests President's rule in Jammu and Kashmir. So after the expiry of 6 months of governor's rule, which has been going on in Jammu and Kashmir, it expires on December 19. Now suggestion has come to impose president's rule in the state. Then there is no relevant news on the international page. On the business page, you have ILNFS to monetize road assets. So the company seeks interest from potential investors for the 10,092 kilometer of projects which it has with it. So here you can see this is the biggest sale of road projects in the country, because ILNFS is under trouble. So it is having these road assets sold now. And this is SEBI's Nasdaq model for platform. So startups need exclusive marketplace. So that is why now SEBI is considering, you know, trying to create a platform like Nasdaq for technology startup firms in India. So it will be tweaking the norms of institutional trading platform. So, you know, so it has got a new name to now, and also a framework largely based on feedback received from the industry participants. And on the last page, you have this news. Israeli spacecraft gets a special rider. So Israeli scientists are making final preparation to launch the country's first spacecraft to the moon. So this is regarding that. So it has various drawings by children, pictures of Israeli symbols like the flag, etc. also on a disc, which it should be, you know, a time capsule of three digital discs, which will be sent along with the spacecraft. So it will be Falcon 9 rocket from American entrepreneur Elon Musk's SpaceX firm that will take this satellite up in space. So this spacecraft has been called Beresheet or Genesis. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asia.com in the current affairs section. Here you can see we have a separate online current affairs course, the details of which you will be able to avail here. And also you can download the PDFs for current affairs. So daily current affairs PDFs uploaded here by the end of the day. So this can be freely downloaded here. So that is it. Thank you.